Do you take your morning coffee with loads of cream, or do you prefer it black? Nearly 70% of the global population is lactose intolerant, meaning they experience some discomfort when it comes to digesting dairy products. But to understand exactly why this is the case, we'll have to break things down and learn a little bit about the catalysts in our bodies called enzymes. Enzymes are just proteins that help to speed up chemical reactions. Chemical reactions can involve a reactant being broken down into multiple products, or multiple reactants forming a singular product, but there needs to be a bit of energy provided to break the bonds and get the molecules in a state where they're able to trade places with each other. By the end of a reaction, the products could gain more energy than the reactants initially had, which is called an endergonic reaction, or they could have lost some energy and released it out into the world as heat, which is an exergonic reaction. Think of it like putting money in the stock market. You can either lose or gain money from your investments, but you have to deposit something initially or else you're not really making an investment at all. Without this activation energy as a barrier, every single possible reaction or investment could take place and chaos would ensue.
But what happens when we actually need a lot of these reactions to happen quickly?
Our metabolism depends on the speed of all the chemical reactions in our body, and we want it to be somewhat efficient so we can survive. That's when we turn to enzymes. Enzymes have a specialized shape, like all proteins, that determines their function. They have active sites, which perfectly fit the shape of the reactants, or substrates, like a puzzle piece. Once a substrate bonds to an enzyme's active site, the enzyme works to lower the activation energy needed for the reaction to happen, either by getting the reactants into their proper positions, stabilizing the transition state, or even participating as an intermediate in the reaction to speed things up. This lower activation energy essentially lowers the criteria for investing, allowing more reactions to take place than normally could without the enzyme there. The lactase enzyme in the small intestine breaks down the lactose in dairy products into its glucose and galactose subunits, which can be easily digested. Those with a lactose intolerance don't make enough lactase, which means lactose isn't getting broken down as quickly, and it's instead becoming food for the bacteria in the digestive tract, which in turn create gases that cause the classic gastrointestinal symptoms that lactose intolerant people know far too well. By increasing the concentration of an enzyme, we can increase the amount of active sites available for reactions to take place, which will ultimately allow more substrate to be broken down faster. For instance, some lactose intolerant people who love cheese too much to give it up will just take a lactose pill before eating dairy to give them that temporary ability to break down lactose quicker. There are also lactose-free milk products which have already been broken down into galactose and glucose. The glucose does make them a little bit sweeter than their counterparts, but it does prevent the body's digestive system from having to deal with that lactose.
By understanding how enzymes work, we can better understand what causes lactose intolerance and how we can treat it. So the next time someone tells you they think they might be lactose intolerant, just ask them if they've got lactase.